Tonight, we are going to witness the most anticipated match in the history of professional wrestling for the heavyweight championship of the world. Are you ready? Wrestling fans, are you ready for the thousands in attendance and the millions watching around the world from the capital city of the United States of America, Washington, D.C., ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble!
Top of the morning to you. Way to get motivated, huh? Well, while the gospel of the good news is full of love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control, it's not a laid-back message. It's full of action words like seek, pursue, strive, fight, war, and battle. Ecclesiastes 3:8, there's a time to love, a time to hate, time for war, and time for peace. Psalm 34:14, depart from evil, do good, seek peace, pursue it. Romans 14:15, let us pursue the things that make for peace and the things by which one may build up another. 1 Corinthians 14:1, pursue love and desire spiritual gifts. 1 Timothy 6:11, flee from the love of money and pursue righteousness, godliness, faith, love, patience, gentleness. 1 Peter 3:11, turn away from evil and do good and seek peace and pursue it. Romans 15:30, through the Lord Jesus and through the love of the Spirit, strive to pray. So we have an enemy whose job is to lie, cheat, and steal from us. John 10:10 says, the thief comes to steal, kill, and destroy. I, Jesus, came that they may have life and more abundantly. So there's this struggle, and it's a war for our souls. And while we rely on God to fight our battles, we also have a part to play. 2 Corinthians 10:3, though we walk in the flesh, we do not war according to the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty in God, for pulling down strongholds, casting down arguments and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, bringing every thought into captivity to the obedience of Christ. Our God is undefeated. Psalm 24:8, who is this King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. What a great God. But it is a war. Galatians 6:9 tells us that let us not be weary in well-doing, for in due season we will reap if we faint not. So here's the best speech ever to Israel right before going into battle, and we can use it today. Deuteronomy 20, verses 1 through 2. When you go out to battle against your enemies and you see horses and chariots and people more numerous than you, in other words, when life seems overwhelming and the odds are stacked against you, don't let your heart faint. Don't be afraid. Don't tremble or be terrified. In other words, don't let the enemy see you sweat. For the Lord your God goes with you to fight for you and save you. Romans 8:31, if God is for us, who can be against us? Go get them.